Hello everyone, welcome back to the day 2 of NABARD Grade A question series. For day 2, I have come up with the topic field crops. Also, we have launched our NABARD Grade A and Grade B comprehensive courses. These two are the comprehensive courses. And as students are asking about the individual courses, so this NABARD Grade B Paper 3 course is also available, which includes finance and management, development economics and statistics. For NABARD Grade A and Grade B, ARD, statistics and phase 1 mock tests are also available. Apart from this, the NABARD 20% discount is also available. So NABARD 20 is the coupon code which you can use to avail 20% discount on these courses. Now let's begin with the first question. So that is, which of the following is not the feature of field crop? So the first statement is, an agriculture crop grown on the large area. So the very basic requirement for the crop to be a field crop, that it should be used for the agriculture purposes and it should be grown on the large area. So this statement is absolutely correct. Next is, these crops provide food, grain, oil and fiber. Again, a correct statement, because the agriculture crop, the basic agenda is to provide the food, grain or the oil and fiber. So if we look at some of the examples of the fiber crops, they can be cereals, sunflower, cotton, grain. So these are all categorized as the field crops. Next statement is, so again this statement is correct. Next is, major component in the growth of the nation. So when we are talking about the agriculture crop and they are providing the, or they are fulfilling the purpose of providing food, so they automatically fulfills the purpose of being a major component in the growth of the nation. Next statement is, these include fruits and vegetables. So here this statement is incorrect. This is not the feature of the field crop. So complementary question with the field crops is, so you need to answer this in the comment section below, that which of the following does not come under the field crops? Chickpea, okra, cotton, castor or rice. Which of the following is does not come under the field crops? Next question is, on the basis of seasons, field crops can be classified into. So there can be many categories under which these field crops can be divided. They can be divided on the basis of seasons, or they can be divided on the basis of climate, on the basis of root system. So root system can be tap root system, fibrous root or dicot, monocot, and they could be categorized under life, as per the life of the crops. They could be categorized as per the botanical similarities. So these are the different categories under which the field crops can be classified. So on the basis of seasons and climate, do not get confused between seasons and climate. So on the basis of seasons, field crops can be classified into Kharif, Rabi and Zaid crops. Similarly, on the basis of climate, the crops can be divided into tropical and temperate crops. Let's discuss about the Kharif, Rabi and Zaid crops. A very basic question, and you must know about the features of the Kharif, Rabi and Zaid crop. So more popularly known as the monsoon crops, because they are grown during the monsoon season. Rabi crops, or we could say the winter crops, grown during the winter season. Next is the Zaid crop. So the duration between the Kharif and Rabi, the short duration, we categorize that as the summer crop. So when we are talking about the monsoon crops, thus the monsoon months are June to October. Easy to remember this thing. Rabi crops, the winter crops, so October to March. Next is the Zaid crop. So this short duration between this, that is March to June, is categorized as the Zaid crops. Now apart from this, what becomes important is that in 2018, there were 22 mandated crops for which the MSP was decided. Now this is something related to the current and can be asked in the examination. 14 were Kharif crops and 6 were Rabi crops. Other 2 were the commercial crops. Paddy, Jowar, Bajra, Ragi, Maize, Cotton. So these are some of the Kharif crops. Now if we talk about the 6 Rabi crops, then the 6 Rabi crops were wheat, barley, gram, masoor, mustard and safflower. So these were the extremely important Kharif and Rabi crops in India. Next is, following is not the feature of tropical crops. So as I just mentioned, that on the basis of climate, the crops can be categorized as tropical and temperate crops. So first of all, let's look at the features of the tropical and the temperate crop. So tropical crops are, they are majorly belonging to the monsoon season, thus could be known as the monsoon crops, or we could relate it to the kharif crops. They are also known as the monsoon crops. So these tropical crops require warm and humid climate, but at the same time the temperate crops require cooler climates, not necessarily all the time, but cooler climate comparatively is required, and they require less humidity. So for this question, following is not the feature of tropical crops: cold and dry weather, so it's not the feature of tropical crop. Monsoon climate, it's the feature of tropical crops. Next is less water, so more water is required because these are monsoon crops, so this is not the feature of tropical crops. Warm and humid weather, warm and humid weather is required for the tropical crops. The last one being the less sunlight, that is winter solstice, but these tropical crops require longer days, thus more of sunlight. So not the feature of tropical crops. So answer is 1, 3 and 5. These are not the features of tropical crops, but these are the features of temperate crops. Now there's a question for you: rice, wheat, bajra, red gram. So among these crops, which of the following is the temperate crop? This is you need to answer in the comment section below, that among rice, wheat, bajra and red gram, which of the following is the temperate crop. Moving on to the next question, which of the following are known as the seed plants? So phanerogams or spermatophytes, these are known as the seed plants. Why? Because these plants are those which produce seeds, therefore they are known as seed plants. Broadly we can categorize spermatophytes in gymnosperms and angiosperms. So for gymnosperms, the features are they are seed producing, non-flowering, and they have naked seeds. And while we are talking about the angiosperms, in short we can say that they are also seed producing, because they are under the category of spermatophytes. So they are seed producing but flowering plants, and they have covered seeds, or the seeds are covered in ovary. Examples could be the, for gymnosperms, pines, spruce, these are the example of gymnosperms, and sunflower, maple, oak, these are the examples of angiosperms. The next question is, what does cotyledon mean? So among these statements, a primary young plant developing out of embryo, that is more popularly known as seedling. Next is the primary leaf from the germinating seed. Yes, this is known as the cotyledon, or the primary leaf which is in the embryo of the higher plant. So we could say that it's not the main leaf, but it is the seed leaf. So in short, we can say that the seed leaves are known as the cotyledons. Cotyledon can be divided in two categories, the first one being the monocots and the dicots. Very important point to note over here is that monocots and dicots are related to the cotyledon. They have nothing to do with the number of seeds in the plants. So monocot means when the germinating leaf or the primary leaf which is coming out of the seed is single. And on the other hand, for the dicot, there needs to be two leaves. So the monocot, the very famous example of monocot is corn, and another very famous example of dicot is mango. This is the pictorial representation so that you can remember the difference between the monocot and the dicot. What are the other examples of monocot? So bananas, garlic, ginger, grass, onion, rice, these are all the examples of monocot. And for the dicot, the beans, peaches, peppers, mango, these are all the dicots. So this is all for the day 2 of the NABARD question series. We'll come up with the next video soon. Keep revising the concepts for NABARD examination. It's just 1 month away. Thank you so much for watching the video.